a 50-point explosion, a Madison Square Garden record for an opponent. Tonight, the Knicks would like to improve their record as they face the Bulls and the amazing Mr. Jordan.
Budweiser, Beechwood aged for that clean, crisp taste. This Bud's for you. Buy Metropolitan Life and affiliated companies. Get Met. It pays. By Coca-Cola. Catch the wave. By Mazda Cars and Trucks. The more you look, the more you like Mazda value. And by Manufacturers Hanover. The financial source. Worldwide.
They expect 15,000 here at Chicago Stadium in the windy city of Chicago, Illinois. And the Knicks and the Bulls are getting ready. Hi, everybody. Marv Albert with John Andres. And tonight, the Knicks and the Bulls will meet for the second time this season. And the big story here in Chicago and, of course, around the NBA has been the magnificent play of Michael Jordan. Hit the 50 points against the Knicks at the Garden. He comes in averaging 38.4 points per game to lead the NBA in scoring. What can the Knicks do to stop Jordan? That is short of trying to lock him in the Bulls locker room.
He's so great to watch. What a great player. And the Knicks found that out in New York last time. Marv, I think what they have to do is react better to him and quicker. Two and three men have to come over and pick up Michael Jordan when he gets the ball. It's as simple as that. It sounds good and it sounds easy, but it has to be done quickly. That did not happen in New York. The Knicks would like to see other people as much as possible shooting the basketball. This is not a very good basketball team when Michael Jordan is the only man doing the action out there. I mean, these guys are getting a much better reputation than their talents in prior years deserve. So Jordan cannot be allowed to elevate them all by himself. Big thing, though, to repeat again, I'm sure Hubie Brown has done it a lot. Double and triple team, but real quick, Marv.
All right, and led by Jordan, this Chicago Bull ball club is 5-3. The Knicks come in at 3-8. They were beaten by the Sixers in Philadelphia on Wednesday night, and that Patrick Ewing enigma continues. Got an early foul trouble and also scored only 10 points. He was invisible. This after a couple of good ball games against Milwaukee and Washington.
Bob, the Knicks are very concerned about this, and what they're going to try and do is let Patrick Ewing establish himself defensively in the game first, then get into his offense. The way they will try and do that is to help him more than they have in prior games. When he's isolated, when those situations come up with his man, they want to help switch out, give him help, let him stay underneath, or when he is isolated, let another guard or forward come over and help him so he's not left in a one-on-one situation. Offensively, what the Knicks want to do is spread the court out more and let the Chicago Bulls worry about the Knicks' front line, and they are concerned about it, and I know that because Doug Collins told me so.
Very nice, John. You've certainly captured every aspect of tonight's ball game. We'll be back with the starting lineups right after we pause for these messages.
And now, to honor America, would you please stand for our national anthem? This is the starting lineup for the...
We're set for the introduction of the starting lineups. Let's join with the public address here at Chicago Stadium.
Set for the introduction in a rather theatrical fashion.
for the Chicago Bulls.
Your Chicago Bulls, as they say here.
Introduction of Earl Cureton, seven-year man from the University of Detroit, former Sixer, former Piston. And here is Charles Oakley, who has had a terrific start, coming off a solid rookie year out of Virginia Union. At center, Granville Waiters, four-year man from Ohio State, who you would have to say at this point is stopgap at the center position. Steve Coulter, former Portland Trailblazer, in his third year out of New Mexico State. And the introduction of guess who? Coach Doug Collins. As you look at the Chicago Bulls, who have not played since last Friday night, when they were beaten here by the Boston Celtics. And there's Terry Durham and Joe Crawford getting set to work tonight's game, although from the expression on their face, you would not realize that. Always an interesting freeze, as they say, in the TV business of the officials at the start of the game.
They don't want to be caught smiling, right, as a rule, because they're here on serious business, but...
As you are.
Generally, that's right, Marv. This is happens to be a very serious game for the New York Knicks, I'll tell you. But the Bulls, as you mentioned, a week off. When do you get a week off in the NBA? But the scheduling worked out that way, and they had to emulate games and practices, and they worked very hard this week, and they could show some rustiness off their fine start.
They lost to the Boston Celtics 110 to 90 last Friday night. And now they have a busy stretch coming up. They're home for the Bullets.
Just under 10 points a game.
6'9 forward from Virginia Union, number 34, Charles Oakley.
Charles Oakley averaging just under 18 points a game and over 13 and a half rebounds a game.
From Ohio State, 6'11, number 35,
Granville Waiters gets a start at center. There was some question as to whether he'd be able to go. He injured an ankle yesterday. And Steve Coulter opens in one guard spot. And here comes Mr. Jordan. And Kirsten at the forward spots, Waiters in the middle, Coulter and Jordan at the guard line. The officials tonight, Joe Crawford and Terry Durham.
And the trainer is Mark Bond. The officials for tonight's game.
There'll be some interesting matchups tonight. The Bulls will play Oakley on Walker, Waiters on Cartwright, Cureton will guard Patrick Ewing, and then the guards would be, as you would expect, Coulter and Sparrow in one matchup, and Jordan and Wilkins in the other. The Knicks are 1-7 on the road, 3-8 overall. Won the season series last year, 4 out of 6.
Looks like we're going to have another big crowd here, Jim. They keep funneling in.
Big crowd expected for tomorrow night, too. Tomorrow night, of course, you get the concert with the ball game. The Climax concert presented by Bud Light. Waiters and Ewing to go up. Joe Crawford will throw it in the air. And the tip is controlled by New York. Rory Sparrow comes into the front court. Sparrow at the top of the key, guarded by Coulter. Right corner, Walker. He comes up shooting and hitting. Kenny Walker gets the Knicks out 2-0. Pressure in the backcourt. Coulter avoids Sparrow and comes into the front court. Steve Coulter to the right side. Michael Jordan foul line. Looks low for Waiters. Now hook pass intercepted by Ewing, and then he traveled with the ball before he could get it down on the dribble. Patrick Ewing had made the steal, but quickly turned it over again.
Well, it showed again, Wilkins getting some good help as Jordan came off a screen, Jim. They gave him a double team right away.
Charles Oakley looks to inbound. He comes into Coulter. Cureton has it out front. Kiraton between the circles, left side Jordan, and an offensive foul on Waiters, setting the pick that got Jordan free.
Randall Waiters is first.
New York, the ball, a 2-0 lead. Sparrow strolls into the front court. Top of the circle, standing dribble against Coulter. Here's a pass kicked by Coulter, and they'll load the shot clock and give the Knicks the ball. Foul line extended right.
Well, they went to Bernard King, their small forward, for a long time, Jim, and now they're going right away to Kenny Walker.
New York looking to come in. It comes into Cartwright. Sparrow with the ball back, top of the key. Left corner is Wilkins. Over the top, Ewing. Turnaround shot blocked out of bounds by Michael Jordan from behind. Patrick Ewing trying to post the shorter Earl Kiraton.
The Knicks have a problem, Jim, is with the guards. The Knicks guards have not been able to hit the open shot. Michael Jordan just slapped it away.
Here's Sparrow with a shot left to the key. Good. Rory Sparrow hits the shot, and the Knicks have a 4-0 lead. Steve Coulter coming left. Outside left is Charles Oakley. Coulter has it back on the dribble to the top of the key. Michael Jordan right of the circle. Jump pass left to Coulter. He sidesteps Ewing in the lane off to Oakley for the layup. Good feed by Coulter, and Charles Oakley gets the layup. Knicks a 4-2 lead. And the ball. Sparrow, top of the circle, runs it through his legs against Coulter. Down the lane, Walker, and a reach-in foul on Waiters. Granville Waiters has picked up his second foul. Rory Sparrow looks to bring it in. He flips it in left corner to Walker. Sparrow has it back, shoots it up left of the key. Yep, the Knicks perfect and lead at 6-2. Steve Coulter into the front court with a behind-the-back dribble hounded by Sparrow. Knicks, of course, will give you various sets of full-court pressure. Inside is Oakley, but off the ball we get a foul called on Charles Oakley. An offensive foul getting set up in the low post.
Two offensive fouls on the Bulls now down here. And one stepping out by Granville Waiters on the other end.
Rory Sparrow on the walk against Coulter. Coming left, shot clock at 16. Ewing low left, turnaround, jumper, nope. Rebound on the floor. Michael Jordan out on the dribble. Jordan into the front court. Jordan outside on the drive, in on Sparrow, to the hoop, lays it in. It's a 6-4 game. Jordan just split the middle of the New York defense. Sparrow right side, pressured by Coulter. He's lost the dribble. Into Cartwright, low right across the lane. Lays it up with the left hand, no good. Waiters the rebound. Waiters has picked it up, now flips it off to Coulter. Steve Coulter up court to Oakley. Oakley a lob into Kiraton, back to Oakley. Right wing shot by Charles, around and out. Rebound tipped away and out of bounds. It belongs to New York. The Knicks have it from three-quarter court. Leading by a hoop. 9:20 for the quarter. Kenny Walker outside to the left, holds it knee high against Oakley. Down the lane, Sparrow lost it off the dribble. Walker gets it back, foul line jumper. Missed. Walker his own rebound, back up and in. Nice play by Kenny Walker.
Boy, is he active, huh, Jimmy?
He beat a tough man to the hoop, Oakley. Oakley has it outside left, guarded by Ewing. Over the top to Kiraton, wheels on Walker, inside, we get a whistle. Got a foul called as Kiraton went to the hoop, tough. Foul is on Walker, that's the first foul of the game again.
Got the ball, he knew he had Walker leaning on him on the inside, but it's a non-shooting foul, first one by Knicks. Kenny Walker picks it up, Charles inbound on the side.
Oakley will bring it in, foul line extended left, and he triggers to Coulter. Kiraton backdoor to Michael Jordan, tipped away, it's out of bounds. It belongs to the Bulls, last touch by Gerald Wilkins. Knicks may lead the league in Gerald's now that they've picked up Gerald
Henderson. Well, Wilkins did a good job on him up in New York early. Remember that, Jim?
Yep, Michael with a ball, foul line, fakes on Wilkins, lean in, jump, air ball. It's grabbed off the deck by Ewing. Jordan got bumped going up, no foul call, and the Knicks come back the other way. Walker double team down low left, gets it out to Sparrow. He shoots it up left to the key, good. Sparrow with six.
Their guards couldn't find the gym in Madison Square Garden. Now he's 3-for-3.
And his team leads it by six. Steve Coulter calling a play on the walk. Coulter between the circles, right side Oakley. Down the lane, Jordan. It went through his hands, and it's out of bounds. Last touch by Cartwright. The Bulls will come in with 12 to shoot, and Gerald Wilkins getting up slowly.
He got hit with a pick on that weak side, and down he went. That's when Michael was so free underneath.
Oakley to make the inbounds pass to the left of the hoop. His inbounds pass is kicked now. The Bulls will get a new 24. Hey, kicked it. Yep, new 24. The Bulls get a new 24 and will trigger it now. Not on the baseline, but rather foul line extended to the left. Charles Oakley flips it into Coulter. Kiriton has it between the circles. Left side, Jordan. Michael around a waiter's pick, and we get an offensive foul off the ball.
Granville on number three, isn't it?
Yep. Corzine replacing Waiters.
But Granville got in trouble that time trying to help. He dribbled the ball in. They said it's a turnover. The Bulls have the ball.
Yep. So the Bulls get a break here as now they blow the whistle to let the Knicks get set up. Oakley inbounding to Jordan. Michael Jordan outside on the walk. Right side is Oakley. Oakley holding on Patrick Ewing. 12 on the shot clock.
Need some help.
Corzine comes to get it against Cartwright. Out to the left is Kiriton. Here's a stolen pass. Kenny Walker, a steal of Kiriton's pass on the break. Sparrow, he blows the layup, but Ewing is there to follow it in. Patrick Ewing with his first hoop. And New York has an 8-point lead with 7:39 left to go in the quarter. Michael Jordan walks into the front court. Oakley holds to the right and off the ball in illegal defense against the Knicks. We've had a little of everything here in the first four and a half minutes.
We've had a walking in out of bounds, illegal defense, a couple offensive fouls, tripping foul, traveling, everything on this thing.
Charles Oakley looks to bring it in. He flips it into Jordan. Kiriton hands to Michael Jordan coming left. It's Jordan against Wilkins, isolated. Michael to the baseline, comes up shooting, no good from the left. Kenny Walker the rebound, and the Knicks come out running. Gerald Wilkins in on Coulter, lays it in. New York has a 10-point lead. They've run off eight in a row. And Steve Coulter coming into the front court. The Bulls take time with 7:07 left to go in the quarter. Timeout here at Chicago Stadium. New York 14, the Bulls 4. Back after these messages on the Bulls Network.
Hi, Tom Baudette.
Points, and they've opened up a 10-point lead at 14-4 with 7:07 left to go in the quarter. Well, we knew, John, the Bulls would come out one of two ways, right?
Yeah, we talked about is it good to have that layoff, but if you look at the difference in the shooting, the Bulls only got five shots at the basket, 12 for the Knicks. They've capitalized, and Walker has really been an exciting player here in the first couple minutes of this game.
He's been extremely active. At the timeline, Charles Oakley will make the inbounds pass. He comes into Jordan. Right side is Oakley. Right of the key, Corzine. Out to the left is Coulter. Coulter with 10 to shoot, gives to Jordan. Right of the lane, shot by Michael is in. Michael Jordan with four. That ends the run of eight straight, and now the Bulls need to turn it at the other end. Rory Sparrow, a standing dribble between the rings. Sparrow guarded by Coulter. Bounce pass down low left to Ewing. In on Kiriton. Missed the shot. Rebound. Oakley corrals it. Charles lets the traffic clear and flips it off to Coulter. Steve Coulter off to the right. Back to Oakley. Top of the circle. Left corner, Michael Jordan. He comes up shooting from the corner. Missed it. Corzine, the rebound. Leads it back out to Coulter. Coulter left to the lane. Shot. No. Rebound, Earl Kiriton. Back up with a fake, no to Jordan, and Michaels reverses in.
Earl Kiriton keeping the ball alive. That's what their big people do, Jim.
Corzine one time and Kiriton the next, and it's a 6-point New York lead. Right corner, Kenny Walker. Walker against Kiriton. Dumps the ball off, but he was fouled as he came into the lane. The foul is on Earl Kiriton. He wasn't in a shooting posture. He was dumping the ball off.
I thought that was on Michael. Take a look. He drives on Kiriton, and Michael comes in to help his teammate out, and he swings at the ball. Looks like he catches him right across the wrist.
It is on Michael. And they say a shooting foul. Walker's eyes weren't on the hoop, though, were they?
I thought he was still coming. Well, I don't. Yeah, Michael got him on that left wrist.
Kenny Walker drops that first one right through.
Kenny Walker drops them both down. Walker with six. 5:50 left to go in the first quarter. Knicks half-court trap. Jordan has it out to the left. Cureton swings to Corzine. Right baseline shot is in. Good job against the gambling defense of the Knicks.
Yeah, and again, Jim, we will say it. We have not seen a defense, a half-court defense, that has really bothered the Bulls over a stretch of time.
Rory Sparrow off to the right, dancing on the dribble at the three-point stripe. Down low right, Cartwright. Turnaround shot on Corzine is in. On a difficult shot, Bill Cartwright hit. 18-10, the Knicks an eight-point lead. Here's Coulter down the lane. All the way to the hoop, had it knocked away from him, out of bounds, off of Coulter, and the Knicks have it. Bulls early, really not taking care of the ball. Six turnovers. Of course, a number of them have been forced, but about two or three of them, though, are offensive fouls. Oakley just missed a foul, and Walker misses the shot from the right baseline. Bulls on the run. Earl Cureton takes it in on Walker and takes it back outside. Cross court to Jordan. Michael spins left of the lane, in on Wilkins. Double pump jumper. Good off the glass. Michael Jordan has eight of the 12.
Cureton made a great play here, Jim, by not going for the hoop, you know, grabbing it and holding it up.
Rory Sparrow, left baseline, Kenny Walker. He fires, missing. Rebound tipped off to Oakley. Here come the Bulls. Charles Oakley slips a bouncer to Jordan. Michael down the lane to the hoop, left hand layup.
Oh,
in.
Wow!
It's a four-point game with 4:18 left.
Oh, is he lefty or righty?
Rory Sparrow outside left, a lob into Patrick Ewing. Low left, turns, fakes, lean-in shot on Cureton is missed. Rebound loose on the floor. Kenny Walker follows it in.
He came over Oakley's back that time, but Walker was right there to put it in.
I tell you what, Cureton is doing a number on Ewing defensively. We'll talk about it in a moment. Here's a pass into Cureton down low left against Walker. Cureton's fadeaway jump is in from the left baseline. Earl Cureton keeps the Bulls within four. What Cureton did to Ewing the last time down was, as soon as he felt that contact, he backed away, remember?
Yeah,
on that post-up play.
Let him get the shot.
Nope, and that left Ewing off balance as he went for the layup. Here is Wilkins in low left, and Jordan a reach-in foul, and that's the second foul on Michael Jordan. John Paxson is coming on. Pat Cummings is in for the Knicks. Coulter is out as Paxson is in, and Cartwright is out as Cummings is in. Gerald Wilkins, a 70% free throw shooter. 3:34 left to go in the opening quarter.
Yeah, that's a difference in alignment. Usually, Cureton takes a small, quick forward, but now Charles has got him, and Cureton is doing a good job on Patrick Ewing, as you mentioned.
Yes, he is. Wilkins missing the first free throw, and now he'll have one remaining. On Wednesday, New York lost by four at Philadelphia. Wilkins had his career high in assists. And Rory Sparrow, the rebound on the Wilkins second miss. So the Knicks get another crack at it. Sparrow at the top of the circle. Right side, Gerald Wilkins spins in low right. Scoop pass off to Ewing for the jam, coming in for the right. Patrick Ewing with four. And the Knicks have a six-point lead. Paxson controlling for the Bulls. Angles off to the right. Into Corzine, low right. Turnaround shot on Ewing. Nope. Patrick Ewing the rebound. Outlet pass stolen by Cureton. Cureton to the hoop. Dig! Jammed it right over Ewing. Earl Cureton.
Not only stole the ball, Jim turned around and put it right down Ewing's throat.
Whoa, my. 22-18. The stadium is buzzing. Rory Sparrow off to the right. Works right of the lane, runs into Paxson, lean in shot, bank no good. Oakley the rebound, lost it out of bounds because when he came down with it, he came down over the back of Cureton. And UB Brown takes time. Timeout, Knicks, 2:37 left in the quarter. It's New York 22, the Bulls 18. Back after these messages.
Returns to Chicago Stadium. The Bulls and Bud Light are proud to present Climax in Concert tomorrow night immediately following the Bulls-Bullets game. Just buy a ticket to see the Bulls take on Manute Bol and the Washington Bullets and then hear the hits of Climax for free. Tickets for this and every Bulls game are available at Chicago Stadium box office. All Ticketron locations or charge by phone. Call 853-3636.
Here's Walker with a shot out of the right corner, no good. And on the rebound, we have a loose ball foul on Dave Corzine.
Loose ball foul, Dave Corzine.
New York back to the free throw line. It's only the fourth team, I'm sorry. And now the Knicks have it in play. Gerald Wilkins out to the left, a standing dribble. Walker has it top of the circle. Looked for Sparrow, cutting low, feeds it left to Wilkins instead. Wilkins against Jordan, in from the left, reverse layup, partially blocked, off to Walker, right baseline shot is in. Boy, the Knicks have taken advantage of their second opportunities.
Yeah, that one fell right into Kenny's hands, but it was facing up, and all he had to do was jump and shoot it.
New York back to a six-point lead. Oakley holds the ball to the right, shot clock at 13. Out front is Corzine, off to the left is Paxson. Right side, Michael Jordan, 15-footer. Rimming, no. Kenny Walker, another rebound. What a first quarter he's played. Kenny Walker pushes it up on the drive. Head of the circle shot, Rory Sparrow, won't go. Rebound tipped away, and Corzine grabs it off the deck, ahead to Jordan. Michael in on Gerald Wilkins, shoots it up, got it blocked, but a foul on Gerald Wilkins.
Boy, even when a guy doesn't have full control of the ball, his body knows where it wants to take it. Came down a right sideline and just bore left. He lost a little bit of control, but caught a body and put it up and in.
Now Kenny Walker goes out of the game. Louis Orr is in. And the Knicks also bring Gerald Henderson in to give them an all-Gerald backcourt. Henderson and Wilkins at the guard line. Michael Jordan to shoot two. Free throw off the back of the rim. Michael came into the game shooting 81% from the foul line, his scoring average at 38.4, tops in the league. The second attempt by Jordan. That one's no good. Brad Sellers has also come in the game for the Bulls, replacing Oakley. Louis Orr, top of the key, plays it left to Wilkins, down the lane, scoop shot, blocked by Curitan, ball on the deck, dug out by Corzine. Off to Paxson. John Paxson pushes it up in a hurry. Takes it in the lane, 13-footer. Nope. Rebound, Curitan. Off to Jordan. Michael in for the right pump shot. Rimming, no. And taken down by Patrick Ewing. Henderson has it now. Knicks up the court in a hurry. In from the right is Cummings. Reverse layup is in. A no-look reverse layup by Pat Cummings. The Knicks an 8-point lead. John Paxson on the walk out front, guarded by Henderson. Paxson left around a Corzine screen. Paxson's holding the ball out front, plays it left to Brad Sellers, 6 on the clock. Here's Paxson with it now, 3 to shoot. Pax down the lane, pull-up jumper from the right is in. First hoop for Paxson, the Bulls within 6, and 42 seconds left in the quarter. Gerald Wilkins holding it out front. Elston Turner at the scorer's table.
He said no foul on Michael now. Right. I don't want to get him in this.
Going to get Turner into the game before the quarter ends, possibly. Wilkins down the lane. Right side, Henderson. Baseline right. Shoots out of the corner. Missing. Brad Sellers the rebound. Hands the ball to Michael Jordan. 19 seconds. No shot clock. The Bulls will play for one. Michael Jordan walks into the front court. 10 seconds. Sellers with the ball way off to the right. Corzine out of high right, 6. Jordan baseline right, trying to get free, shoots under pressure. Bank no. Rebound Pat Cummings as the quarter comes to an end. It's a 6-point New York lead, 26-20 on the Bulls Basketball Network.
Fans, it's time for the Halo advertising.
John, we're reaching 38 states across the country on the big strong signal of WMAQ. Tonight we're going farther than that.
Hey, we want to welcome everyone listening on the Armed Forces Radio Network. Jimmy, that is all over the world.
There you go. In the first quarter tonight, the Knicks shooting 44% from the field. The Bulls an even 50. New York out-rebounded the Bulls 12-11. The Bulls had 6 turnovers to the Knicks 3.
Hart right now in at center. Ewing is out, and here comes a little pressure.
John Paxson brings it up against Gerald Henderson. Paxson outside to the left. Elston Turner in the game, replacing Michael Jordan. Paxson left of the key, picks it up, gives to Brad Sellers. Sellers against Cartwright. Elston Turner over the top to Corzine, low right against Cummings. 4 on the clock. Right corner Turner, and he had the ball knocked away from him. It's loose to Henderson. 24-second violation. The Knicks didn't gain control of the ball until the 24-second clock went off.
I think the layoff hurt the Bulls so far.
Yep,
I agree.
They're down by half a dozen with 11 and a half left in the half. Henderson outside left. Gives it up to Louis Orr, top of the key. Right side is Sparrow. Low right Cummings, missed steal Curitan, and a reach-in foul on Elston Turner as Cummings went for the hoop. Elston Turner with his first foul.
They said he was going to the hoop on it, too. Looked like he had not quite collected to get there, but they give Pat Cummings a chance to shoot a couple here. They're 500 from the line, Jim. They made two, missed two. Walker with the two makes, and Gerald Wilkins with the two misses.
Cummings drops the free throw in. Shooting 72% from the foul line on the season. His second attempt is around and in. 28-20, the Knicks lead by eight. Good-sized crowd in Chicago Stadium. The Bulls are averaging 15,800. And the Bulls turn it over against that half-court trap.
It's got to be seven or eight turnovers now. That's eight at least.
We're six at the quarter, and it is eight now. 8-3. Bulls have eight turnovers to the Knicks three. Here's Paxson knocking the ball away, but a kicking violation as Paxson kicked the ball. So the Knicks have it with a brand new shot clock and 11:05 left in the half. Henderson inbounding to Orr in the left corner. Gerald Henderson on the drive, comes foul line and fires. Rims it no good, tipped in, however, by Bill Cartwright. Cartwright with 4 points tonight. The Knicks have equaled their largest lead at 10. 10:45 left to go in the first half. John Paxson, top of the circle, shoots a 20-footer. Good. Paxson with four. Bulls need a good defensive set here. On the dribble left is Henderson. Paxson guarding him. Gerald Henderson has picked it up. Dumps it into Cartwright, low left. He wheels on Corzine, has the shot blocked. It's cleared by Corzine. Corzine up court to Turner. Elston Turner on the drive into the front court. Has picked it up left side. Paxson shoots another 20-footer. Good from the top of the key. Almost like an instant replay.
His coach told him, Doug said, I want you to take around 14 shots a game, John. You got to look up when Michael's not there.
Well, he's hit two in a row, and the New York lead is six. Right side, Louis Orr. Fakes on Sellers. Baseline right. Sellers covers up. Pass into Cummings. Kicked away. Orr gets it back. Nine to shoot. Lob pass stolen by Curitan. They overthrew Cummings. Turner to Paxson. Middle of the break. John Paxson down the lane right side. Shoots it up. And in. No basket. A foul called before the shot. Have we seen continuation this year, and have we seen no continuation this year?
That was a good call. That was really a good call the way it should be called, but sometimes they don't do it. And Rory Sparrow gives him a bump.
Sparrow with his first foul. Bulls have it in play. Curitan with it, top of the circle. Right side is Paxson. Right corner, Brad Sellers. Sellers with 16 to shoot, gives to Paxson. He drives in from the right and laid it in. That's what the outside jumpers did.
Yeah, absolutely. They had to come out and challenge him once he hit those outside jumpers. He's got three outside and a nice drive.
30-26. The Bulls have run off six in a row. Henderson right side leans over the dribble. Gives it up to Cummings. Cummings baseline right to the hoop. Reverse layup is in. That's two that Pat Cummings has made that way. Cummings with six. Paxson controlling for the Bulls. Bounce pass into Curitan. Low right against Cummings. Curitan takes it out on the dribble. 13 on the shot clock. Left side Sellers. He steps in. Lean in shot. Bank no good. Rebound tipped off to Elston Turner. He powers up underneath. Missed the layup. Curitan follows it in. Earl Curitan, what an effort.
Well, he's getting a lot of minutes, and you know why. He just showed you.
32-28. 4-point Knick lead. Sparrow off to the right. Standing dribble guarded by Turner. Off the ball, a whistle.
Johnny Pax picks that one up.
Yep, John Paxson with his first foul.
There he was, Jim, trying to step out in front of a big man. Gerald Wilkins back in the lineup.
And Rory Sparrow inbounding the ball to Orr. Sparrow has it back, shoots a 20-footer right of the circle, bullseye. Rory Sparrow with eight. Came in averaging 11.6. 34-28. Elston Turner standing dribble between the rings. Takes it off to the right, shot clock hits 13. Brad Sellers left of the circle, a bounce pass left of lane to Curitan. Back out to Sellers, left wing shot from 20. Right there, the Bulls crawl back to within four as Brad Sellers mails one in from the perimeter.
Get a little more confidence too. Jimmy's blocked the shot now, got a rebound. Put that ball in the hole.
Outside to the left holding is Louis Orr. Charles Oakley ready to come back for the Bulls. Inside Wilkins, turnaround shot blocked from behind by Sellers, but a foul call. Brad Sellers picks up the personal foul. Charles Oakley replacing Earl Carrington, and Earl Carrington gets a hand as he heads for the bench.
Well-deserved hand. Nice hand by Earl. For Earl, I mean.
Gerald Wilkins back on the line to shoot two.
What's the trap? What's the trap?
Misses the first one. He's 0 for 3.
Check out.
Now the shooter.
Check out.
I believe Rory Sparrow got that last one. He stepped in, so now Elston Turner will be the man that has to jump out and get the shooter.
Gerald Wilkins again. That one is in. 3 points for Wilkins, and New York leads 35-30. The Knicks are showing half-court trap as John Paxson comes into the front court. Wilkins chases him out to the left. Paxson dribbles to the middle of the floor. Now he's double-teamed right side. Off to Turner. Ball knocked free. Batted to Sellers, though. Underneath pass stolen by Louis Orr, intended for Corzine. And the Knicks take it back the other way. Gerald Wilkins right of the lane, in the lane, lean-in jumper, rimming no, tipped around, batted out to Turner, Bulls with the ball. Elston Turner slows it down, a hoop makes it a three-point game. Elston Turner right of the circle, 15 to shoot, low right is Corzine against Pat Cummings. Turnaround jumper, good. Corzine in a post-up of Cummings. 35-32. The Knicks, who have enjoyed leads of 10, now lead by only 3. Michael Jordan ready to come back with 7:06 left of the half. Rory Sparrow, right side, standing dribble, picks it up. Down low right, Cartwright. Right corner shot, Sparrow. Ring it
oh
up.
Oh, boy, they couldn't make one in New York with the guard spot. Wait a minute, what happened here? Foul on.
Foul on Pat Cummings. Loose ball foul on Pat Cummings after the hoop.
Second team. Michael Jordan for Elston Turner.
Sparrow's season high this year did come opening night against the Bulls, 24.
Yeah, but I think he had a lot of layups and shots. I can't remember making those 20-footers.
Timeout taken by the Bulls with 6:56 left in the half. The New York lead is 5, 37-32. We'll return after these messages on the Bulls Network.
Temperatures reach an all-time high with no end in sight for the next 5 days. This weather report brought to you by
Mike's Hard Lemonade. When things heat up, a hard Mike's is good to find.
And on Wall Street, pork belly is reaching
Jump for joy. With new Odor Eaters Plus. Odor Eaters.
And Corzine and Sellers rounded out in this second quarter. The Bulls are 6 of 8 from the field. The Knicks are 4 of 8. And the Bulls have it to work the length of the floor. John Paxson, under pressure of Rory Sparrow, works into the front court. Paxson off to the right. Stops his dribble, dumps it into Oakley, low right, back to Paxson in the corner, back into Oakley, turnaround jumper by Charles, rimming no, and Kenny Walker way up for the rebound. Rory Sparrow in the New York front court. Walker, a bounce pass low left to Cummings, he wheels, shoots on Oakley, got it. Pat Cummings low left, Cummings with 8, the Knicks lead by 7. New York has scored the last 4. 6:20 left to go before halftime. John Paxson, bounce pass to Michael Jordan, right of the key, now to Corzine, low right. 12 to shoot, Corzine backs in the lane, shoots it up, banked it in, he shot the ball right over Cartwright. 6 points for Corzine. Rory Sparrow, top of the key, standing dribble. Left of the lane is Cartwright against Corzine. He shoots it up from there. No good from 12, and the rebound to Corzine. Off to Paxson. Johnny Pax on the drive, left of the lane. Left corner, Brad Sellers. He fires good. Brad Sellers with 2 outside jumpers, and it's a 3-point game.
Run that break well. Sellers, instead of going to the hoop, just spread out to the side. Jim got the nice pass.
And UB Brown wants to talk about it with 5:33 left to go in the first half. Timeout New York. Knicks lead by 3, 39-36 on the Bulls Basketball Network.
Get ready for the new NFL season with a full week.
Leading Golden State by 11 in the third quarter at Boston. Pistons lead the Sixers by 5 in the third. And Washington leading Houston by 7 at halftime at the Cap Center.
Here the Knicks lead the Bulls 39-36. New York has it in play. Off to the right, Wilkins on the drive down the lane. Missed the dunk! It's up in the air, up for grabs. Cartwright had it, lost it, gets it back, lays it up, no. Rebound Cartwright, he followed it in. Wow, Gerald Wilkins, when he missed the dunk, the ball ricocheted way up over the shot clock. It was way up there. The Knicks end up with a hoop out of it, though. Paxson with the ball off to the right into Jordan, low right. Turnaround, jumper good. Michael Jordan on the low post. 12 for Jordan, and the Bulls stay within three.
On the floor!
The Bulls bench has outscored the Knicks bench 18-8 to this point. Kenny Walker, baseline left, has it blocked and cleared by Brad Sellers. Here's Michael Jordan in the front court. Michael lost it off the dribble. Kenny Walker gets it back. And he takes it back the other way. Takes it in on Corzine and lays it in. Kenny Walker with 12. 43-38.
Something else on it. Knicks 8 points off the bench.
And Pat Cummings has all eight. John Paxson right side. Pressured by Sparrow. Oakley top of the key. Left side Sellers. Brad fires good. Three straight from the outside for Brad Sellers. The Bulls stay within three. 4:14 left to go before halftime. Rory Sparrow, right side of the New York front court, leans over the dribble, picks it up, plays into Patrick Ewing, low right, outside the pass, loose, knocked out of bounds to the Bulls. It was last touch. Oh, it looked like Kenny Walker last touched it. Joe Crawford says no. Give it to New York.
I'll tell you what, they're getting some pretty good team defense out of Brad Sellers. The young man from our state reaches in to help out Charles Oakley. It sure is.
Yep, he knocked it out all right. Walker buries one from the twilight zone to the right. Kenny Walker with 14. 45-40. John Paxson right side, standing dribble. Sparrow backs off. Paxson the drive to the lane. Pull-up jumper. Got it. John Paxson just drilled a little 10-footer. The Bulls staying within three. Sparrow controlling in the New York front court. Earl Cureton ready to come back for the Bulls. Sparrow a bounce pass to Walker right of the lane. He dribbles out into the corner. Now he runs into Ewing. Off to Sparrow, 10 to shoot. Sparrow at the top of the circle, shoots from 20. Missing. Rebound, Oakley grabs it. Flips it off to Jordan. A hoop makes it a one-point game. John Paxson walks into the front court. Pax directing traffic from out front, walks off to the right. He's hounded by Sparrow. Out front, Oakley. Charles with a fake down the lane. We get a foul call. Foul is on Cummings. That's his second. Cureton replacing Corzine. The Bulls will inbound. Foul line extended to the left. 2:58 remaining in the half. Charles Oakley over the top to Jordan, low right, turnaround shot on Wilkins, bank no, and taken down by Kenny Walker. Rory Sparrow has it now, he storms it up. Sparrow left the lane, plays it low left to Wilkins, he steps in and lays it in. Gerald Wilkins just a step in from the left baseline and he laid it in with the right hand. It's a 5-point lead for the Knicks again. John Paxson on the dribble outside, pressured by Sparrow. Paxson off to Sellers. Brad Sellers dumps it to Paxson out front. Pax steps foul line, shoots it up. No, tipped in by Sellers. Brad Sellers with eight.
Pax got fouled on a play, too.
He sure did. Rory Sparrow outside on the walk. A three-point game. Sparrow takes it off to the right. Standing dribble at the three-point stripe. Bounce pass in, low right, Ewing. Wheels on Oakley, double fake, gets the shot up, banked it in. Offensive foul on Patrick Ewing. Well, he kept forcing the issue. It really wasn't there for him.
Wanted to make it, wanted to take it. Charles wasn't going to leave his feet. Still didn't.
Here's Paxson in the front court. Again, a hoop makes it a one-point game. Michael Jordan left of the lane to the hoop. Reverse layup. Nope, got a foul called on the way to the hoop.
3 seconds.
3 second call.
Charles Oakley.
Sparrow in the Knicks front court. The Bulls have turned it over 11 times in this first half to the Knicks five. Pat Cummings outside jumper good from the top of the circle. Pat Cummings with 10. The Knicks with a 5-point lead. John Paxson into the front court for the Bulls. Sparrow pressures him between the circles. Paxson starts it left to Oakley. Charles passed Ewing to the hoop. Missed the dunk with the left hand. And Cummings the rebound for the Knicks. Up court to Sparrow. On ahead to Kenny Walker. In low right. His shot hits the side of the glass. Wilkins' turnaround shot is around and in. Gerald Wilkins with the offensive rebound and hoop. And the Knicks have a 7-point lead. 1:03 left to go in the half. Just when the Bulls appear ready to mount a run, the Knicks extend it. Here's a foul on Ewing. Reached over the top of Charles Oakley to knock a pass away. Second foul on Patrick Ewing.
You know, I hate to use the word stiff when I talk about Patrick Ewing, but what I've seen of him, Jim, since he's been in the league, saw Granville Waiters and Corzine hold him to 5 free throws for 3/4 of the game. He has not shown me a thing.
He hasn't, me either. He's obviously got some history of injuries. We already had some scores of some other games tonight, with the Warriors playing at Boston tonight. The Pistons are at Philadelphia. Houston starting a long road trip at Washington. Dallas playing at Phoenix later on tonight. The Nets out west against the Lakers, and boy, New Jersey is struggling. And San Antonio will be at Portland later. Celtics have opened up a 17-point lead on Golden State in that game in Boston Garden. And Detroit leads Philadelphia now 87-81.
George Karl has done a good job with that Golden State team.
Yes, he has. Brad Sellers will inbound it. He comes in play to Paxson after the 22nd timeout. Oakley, top of the key, right side Jordan. Michael on the move against Wilkins. Lobs for Paxson, left corner. Pax fires, good. John Paxson's got it stuck on automatic. He's got 12. The Bulls stay within 5. 42 seconds left to go in the half. Sparrow takes it left. Ewing and Walker are out of the play. Out front, Wilkins. Wilkins on the drive, down low left, picked up by Cureton. Out to Sparrow, his 20-footer. Good from left of the circle. Rory Sparrow has 12. 28 seconds left of the half.
52!
Michael Jordan gets a play from Doug Collins and walks into the front court. Shot clock at 16, 5 difference. Oakley holding to the right. Outside is Cureton. 10 to shoot. Jordan has it off to the right, into Oakley, low right, jump hook, around and out. Rebound tipped up in the air. Kenny Walker gets it. Gerald Wilkins has it now on the drive. Wheels in, low right, and traveling called on Gerald Wilkins as he went in out of control. 6 seconds left. The Bulls, plenty of time to come down and score.
They could even get 3. Look around. Nobody looking.
John Paxson has it up court to Sellers. Sellers back out to Paxson. He shoots a 3 from the right side. He goaltended. Cummings had his hand in the net. Hey, he goaltended the ball. No call. Doug Collins out talking to Terry Durham about it. The ball is on the rim as Cummings gets his hand in the net.
You Boom. Cannot
you
do
cannot
that.
Touch
you cannot
anything.
Put that hand in the net.
Oh, my. Well, it's a 7-point New York lead. And the replay shows clearly goaltending on Pat Cummings. Halftime score, New York 53, the Bulls 46. We'll be back with our halftime activities after these messages on the Bulls Network.
Before Michael Jordan stepped onto the court for the start of his third NBA season, there may have been skeptics who felt no way could he top his first 2 years. Jordan's rookie year was storybook. Hyped to the hilt, Jordan lived up to all of it. He promised excitement, and he delivered. And for his work, he earned Rookie of the Year honors. Last year, his season appeared to come to an early finish with a fractured foot. Instead of sitting out the entire campaign, Jordan came back, against management urging, to lead Chicago into the playoffs and against the Celtics. And Jordan had a memorable series. He averaged almost 43 points for the series, and in one game, set an all-time playoff scoring record with 63 points. What Jordan would do for an encore seemed to be the problem this year. During the offseason, the Bulls made numerous player moves, and most NBA followers felt not all were for the better. Except for Charles Oakley, Chicago didn't appear strong up front. Little was expected of the Bulls, which of course suited Michael Jordan just fine.
I love it. You know, everyone's picking us to do somewhat bad, and it takes all pressure off this team. You know, and that's what we need for a young team. We don't need pressure. I think all we have to do now is go out and play, and you know, everybody expects us to do bad. But I think we're still a good basketball team, and we can surprise a lot of people.
Opening night for Chicago and the Knicks, Madison Square Garden, the place where Michael Jordan, in his rookie year, first displayed to the NBA his trademark cradle dunk. If there were doubts that Jordan enjoyed the Garden spotlight, they disappeared by the second half. Time and time again, the Bulls went to Jordan down the stretch, and despite the double-team coverage, he scored 21 of the Bulls' final 31 points, including the final 11. An alley-oop play, and a soaring drive capped off a 50-point performance. More importantly, the Bulls were 1-0. The Garden performance was no fluke. The next night, Jordan had 41 points against Cleveland. Two nights later, 34 against San Antonio. Suddenly, the team picked for last was 3-0. In a season so new, there are still plenty of questions the Bulls have to answer. Can all the new faces blend together? Can the Bulls continue to rely so heavily on one player who's coming off a serious foot injury? Can they win under a rookie coach? On that point, Michael Jordan feels coach Doug Collins fits in perfectly. Because of experiences as a player, Collins certainly understands about foot injuries. His career was ended because of one. The young coach might be exactly what the doctor ordered for a young team.
Well, Doug, he's learning just like any other coach in his position. He's really trying to get to know the players very well, trying to get to understand how to coach in certain situations. And, you know, I think the players respect him a whole lot. I respect him. He's a good coach. He's a good technique type of coach. He takes his time and try to explain everything thoroughly to the players. And, you know, I think he's going to be a good coach.
The cover of Sports Illustrated and the NBA scoring lead are just two of the signs that Michael Jordan has unveiled his third NBA season, a season as unique as the first two. He's still doing it his way, above the court, in the air. When he takes off, he's still using midair to create and amaze opponents and fans alike. But this year, something's different. He's invited the whole team along for the flight.
Come fly with me, let's fly away. Fly with me, let's fly, let's fly. Pack up, let's fly away.
Welcome back to Chicago Stadium. Marv Albert with John Andres at the half. The Knicks leading the Bulls by the score of 53-46. Knicks led by as many as 10. They've led throughout. A good first half for the Knicks and an excellent shooting first half for both ball clubs.
Yes, everybody's really hitting their shots, and I don't think it's a matter of people laying back on the shooters. For the most part, the defense is very solid on both teams' part. The Chicago Bulls have not played in a week, so they're very well rested and capable of a good physical effort. And the Knicks, of course, are highly motivated because of their poor game the other night, and they're up and down play this season, mostly down, so they're up to get a good one under their belt. So the effort is really there physically by both teams, so that, I think, is why the shooting is really impressive.
Michael Jordan, 5-for-13 in the first half, got off to the quick start, and then Doug Collins providing him with a long rest period in that second quarter.
Yes, and he reached down into the bench and found John Paxson there, as he has. Paxson, all of a sudden, is the third leading scorer on this team, but he did his usual full games effort in the first half, absolutely shot the ball great, and that's why Jordan could get the rest, and that's why the Bulls perhaps became more confident as a team. It's really a solid effort by them, Marv.
All right, we're set to take a look at some of the key plays in the first half, and the halftime highlights are brought to you by Minolta, makers of the Freedom line of 35-millimeter autofocus compact cameras. Get freedom for your best shot.
Bill Cartwright doing what the coach says, and that's get those hands up. And he did, forcing the pass. And Kenny Walker goes up and does an amazing thing by pulling that ball out of the air. What a great defensive play. Starts a Knicks fast break. Patrick Ewing is breaking with the action. Rory Sparrow comes up from behind with a great effort. Puts it over the basket, but Ewing arrives on time.
Now, from this camera angle, check out the moves of Michael Jordan.
Charles Oakley, nice bounce pass, very slickly done. Now, you're guarding Jordan, you got him, right?
Yeah.
Forget it. Goes by one, goes by Kenny Walker, goes to the left hand, unstoppable man. The other end, Gerald Wilkins with a fine penetrating move, saw since Patrick Ewing, who came in for one of his very happy moments of the first half.
And at the half, the Knicks by seven. They lead the Bulls 53-46. Well, the Knicks and the Bulls are back on the court. The Knicks leading at the half, 53-46. Good shooting first half by both ball clubs, as we mentioned, as we run down the scoring for the New York Knicks. Kenny Walker, six field goals, 2 out of 2 from the line. He had 14 points. He was 6 of 12 from the floor. And Rory Sparrow with a good shooting first half, 6 of 10 for 12 points. Pat Cummings at 8. Gerald Wilkins with 7. While the Chicago Bulls, led by Michael Jordan and John Paxson. Paxson, 6 of 8 from the field. We'll be back with the start of the half right after these words.
Mark shot 50% from the field, 24 of 48. Chicago shot 56%, 23 of 41. Rebounding, the Knicks have the edge there, 21-18. Turnovers, 11 Bulls turnovers and 7 for the Knicks. And New York capitalized on just about each and every one of those Bulls turnovers. The Knicks scoring 14 points off the 11 turnovers. The Bulls scored 4 points off the 7 New York turnovers.
And Knicks shooting that 50%, Jim, is really amazing because they do not really hurt you from the outside, but their guard, Rory Sparrow, has got 12 points, and I think all of his from 20-foot range. Kenny Walker's mixed it up, but he's had a couple long-distance bombs, and so has Gerald Wilkins. So if they cool off a little bit here, the defense picks up for the Bulls, we can be all right.
Maybe so. Could be a long night for UB Brown after his 341st career victory. Bulls in the front court. Coulter left of the key, plays it wide left to Jordan. Michael on the move, spins left baseline.
Illegal
defense against the Knicks. Second one of the game, technical foul. And so the Bulls will begin the third quarter with a free throw. Michael Jordan, who missed the only two free throw attempts for the Bulls in the first half, on the line. Rims this one no good. Bulls have it in play. Jordan gives to Cureton between the circles. Left side is Steve Coulter. Baseline left. Reload shot missed. Rebound tipped off to Coulter. Takes it back in. He's covered up by Ewing. Coulter has lost the dribble down low left. Now to Michael Jordan on the left wing. 16 on the shot clock. Jordan against Wilkins. Michael left to the lane, in the lane, pumps the shot up, got a foul called as Jordan attacked the basket, and the foul is on Ewing. Patrick Ewing with his third.
Patrick Ewing got him driving down the lane. Michael Jordan coming off the free throw line. Jimmy's missed his first three free throws of the game, missed a technical. Now he steps back up there, Ewing with that third foul. Michael Jordan trying to get his first points of the second half. Oh, he wires that one around the rim and catches it.
After missing three in a row, he drops that one, and he also drops the second one in. And the New York lead is 5. In the front court for the Knicks is Sparrow. Sparrow pressured by Coulter. Right side Walker, 12-footer missed on the right wing. Granville waiters, the Bulls rebound. Michael Jordan on the drive in the front court. Takes it down the lane to the hoop, laid it up, got it blocked by Kenny Walker. The ball loose to Oakley, though. Charles Oakley lost it off the dribble, but Cureton grabs it. Cureton down the lane, gives to Jordan outside left, now to Coulter. Steve Coulter between the circles, right side Oakley. Charles holding it wide right, takes the outside jumper and drills it. Charles Oakley with only his second hoop of the game, but it brings the Bulls within 3. Rory Sparrow at the controls. Sparrow left to the circle. Coulter stripped the ball from him. Just went up and took it away from him. Here's Steve Coulter in the front court. Coulter on the move, baseline right. Can't slide inside. Plays it off to Oakley. Right of the circle, Charles fires. Good. Charles Oakley brings the Bulls within 1, and UB Brown wants a 20. 14,328 making some noise in Chicago Stadium. Scooby Brown using his 22nd timeout early here.
You know, you and I, Jimmy, talking about Michael's 50-point game in New York, we had a look back up what he had at halftime. Today at halftime he had 12 points. He's now got 14 with those two free throws. But in that 50-point game, he only had 16 at halftime. We talked about Gerald Wilkins doing a great job, and that's what it looks like here. But now Charles Oakley picking up the slack, hitting the outside shot. Brings it back to just a one-point game.
What that could do for Charles is the same thing it did for Paxson when he hit his outside shot.
Yes, sir.
Enhance the drive. Here's Sparrow outside left, guarded by Coulter. Dumps it into Cartwright. In the hoop. Puts a hook up and in. Cartwright got a right-handed hook to go. Just flipped that hook up as he came across. 55-52. Steve Coulter pressured by Sparrow on the dribble off to the right. Coulter, a standing dribble at the stripe. Gives it up left to Oakley. Charles shoots it up. Rimming no, left of the key. Tipped in by Jordan. Supposed to be the other way around, isn't it?
But you knew Charles was going to fire it. When you get two, you got to get three.
Michael with 16. The Bulls trail by one. Rory Sparrow to the right side, hounded by Coulter. Sparrow plays it inside, and Waiters knocked it out of bounds, but a foul called on Waiters. They say he reached over the top of Cartwright. That's four fouls on Granville Waiters, whose minutes in the first half tonight were limited to four when he picked up three fouls. Granville is getting his money's worth, though. Rory Sparrow looks to bring it in. Foul line extended right. He comes into Cartwright. Sparrow has it back, top of the key, wheels on Coulter, down the lane, scoops the pass off to Ewing, knocked out of bounds by Cureton. Good play by Earl Cureton.
Well, Cureton's got to pick up the man driving and then worry about getting back to Ewing or have Ewing follow to the board. He's got a tough job.
He's an outstanding defensive player. Here's Wilkins from the right baseline, around and in. Gerald Wilkins rims the shot good from the right baseline. 9 points for him. The Knicks keep the three-point lead. The Bulls unable to overhaul him. Steve Coulter at the foul line. Left corner, Jordan. Michael fakes on Wilkins. Covered up, double team. Left baseline. Out to Oakley. Charles feeds it right corner to Coulter. 8 on the shot clock. Coulter on the dribble right wing. Shoots under pressure. Bank no. Rebound loose. Waiters gets it and takes it back outside to Cureton. Cureton down the lane. In the lane. Shoots on the run. Bank no good. Ewing clears it. Now that's stolen by Coulter. The Bulls are right back on the attack. Michael Jordan in the left corner. Jordan guarded by Sparrow out to the left. Now they double on him. Michael drives free. Lean in jumper. Banked it in.
Oh, he stayed with it, Jim, till I got it right. Good defense by the Bulls. Got him an offensive hoop, right?
Yep. It's a one-point New York lead. Sparrow outside left, lobs it to Ewing, low left, turnaround jumper, around and out. Rebound tipped away to Cartwright. And then he lost it out of bounds. Last touch by Coulter.
That hurt us in the first half. They got 9 offensive rebounds out of the 21.
Baseline left, Rory Sparrow inbounding. He comes into Cartwright. Wilkins left of the circle. Back left corner, Sparrow. He fires good. Rory Sparrow with 14. He is 7 for 12 from the field in the game. The Knicks keep the three-point lead. Steve Coulter between the circles, a standing dribble, pressured by Sparrow. Down low left is Oakley. Charles takes it out on the dribble in the left corner. Shoots on Ewing. Missed the shot. Rebound tipped off to Kenny Walker. Rory Sparrow plays it on ahead to Gerald Wilkins. Left baseline shot by Wilkins. In and out.
Over to
Ewing over the back of Cureton. No call. The rebound off to Coulter anyway. Coulter up court to Oakley. Back outside, Waiters. Left wing is Coulter. Now to Oakley. Baseline left. Charles missed the layup. Got it back. Laid it up. No. Rebound, Waiters. Turn around. Got it. Hey, I think Charles caught his own pass. Did his layup hit anything?
He could have. Now, that wouldn't be the first play that Joey Crawford's missed in his game.
59-58. New York by one. Walker in the lane to the hoop. Laid it up. Got it blocked. Waiters clears it. The Bulls have a chance to get the lead. Steve Coulter into the front court. Flips it left to Oakley. Left baseline, Cureton. Earl fires. Rimming, no. Rebound tipped around. Loose to Sparrow. And the Knicks take it back on the break. Gerald Wilkins to the hoop. Lays it in on the reverse move. And still the Knicks keep the lead. 61-58. 6:45 remaining third quarter. Steve Coulter outside to the left. Stops his dribble.
10 to shoot. Coulter holding left, now into Cureton against Walker. In deep, had it blocked, got it back. Cureton again, rimming, no! Tip try, Walker, Jordan, and taken down by Patrick Ewing. Rory Sparrow up court, feeds it ahead to Wilkins, and he traveled, what's it called?
34.
Foul called on Charles Oakley, trying to get the baseline before he did. Second foul on Oakley, timeout Bulls, 6:22 left to go, third quarter. 61-58, New York by three on the Bulls Basketball Network. Washington doing a number on Houston tonight in the Cap Center, and the Bullets will be here tomorrow. It's 81-64, Washington leading the Rockets in the third quarter. Houston playing without Ralph Sampson. He has sprained both ankles this year. The Bulls in this quarter, 5 of 16 from the field, pure effort. New York, 4 of 8.
New York.
The Bulls have out-rebounded the Knicks in the third quarter, 10-5. You got to feel, John, effort like that will be rewarded before the game is over.
Oh, yes.
New York out Walker, Ewing, Cartwright, Wilkins, and Sparrow. Chicago with Jordan Coulter at the guard spots, Oakley, Corzine, Cureton.
That foul just slowed him up a little bit, doesn't put him to the line.
Yep. The Knicks have it in play. Outside left, Wilkins, guarded by Jordan. Walker, top of the key, one bounce dribble, swings it right side to Sparrow. Low right, Ewing against Cureton. Turnaround jump, missed. Rebound, Jordan. That's 11 boards to 5. Michael Jordan in the front court. Jordan double team, slips through, baseline right, lays it up, no good. Corzine the follow, his layup is missed. And Kenny Walker, the Knicks rebound. Here they come on the run. Wilkins a lob to Ewing for the jam. Patrick Ewing running the court, gets the dunk. He's got 6, and the Knicks lead by 5. Steve Coulter, top of the circle, dancing on the dribble. Michael Jordan's outside shot, good on the right wing. Michael Jordan has 20. That keeps the Bulls within 3. Rory Sparrow off to the left. Coulter guards him. Down low left, Cartwright against Corzine. Turns, gets the shot on the way, and hits it. Bill Cartwright with 10. John Paxson, Brad Sellers ready to come for the Bulls. Pat Cummings ready to come for the Knicks, who lead by 5. Steve Coulter, alley-oop to Jordan. It hits the glass. Kenny Walker outlets the ball to Sparrow, and it's tipped out of bounds by Coulter. John Paxson is in. Coulter is out. Brad Sellers is in. And Charles Oakley is out. Pat Cummings is in. And Cartwright is out. New York with a ball in play. 5:05 left in the third. Bounce pass inside Kenny Walker, and he lays it in. Just took Sellers in deep. First hoop in the second half for Walker. He's got 16 points tonight. And the Knicks have stepped back to a 7-point advantage. After the Bulls had cut it to 1. Dave Corzine down low right. Corzine against Ewing. Turnaround shot in the lane is in. Corzine just hit a little floater out front. 8 points for Corzine. 4.5 minutes left. Rory Sparrow leans over the dribble to the right. Paxson on him. 12 on the shot clock. Sparrow looking for Ewing. Gets it to him against Cureton. Ewing return feed to Sparrow. Sparrow 5 to shoot. Baseline right. Lost it off his leg as Paxson forced the turnover. The Bulls have it as it went out of bounds. Hey, Sparrow's played a lot of minutes in this game.
Yes, he has. Trent Tucker, we saw him walking around in street clothes, Jim. That's another guard they go to right quite readily.
John Paxson coming in the front court. A hoop makes it a 3-point game. Left side, Jordan. Michael baseline left, comes up shooting and hitting. 22 for Michael Jordan, 67-64. Gerald Henderson ready to come back for the Knicks. 3:56 left in the third. Sparrow to the right has stopped the dribble. Plays it into Cummings. Low right against Corzine. Cummings across the lane. Missed the shot. Got it back and hit it off the glass on a follow-up. Pat Cummings with 12. It was almost a pass to himself, wasn't it?
That's right.
And he went up with that shot. Looked like he got fouled. He was still able to control it right back to himself, and he followed it in. Corzine holding right of the circle. Left side, Cureton. Paxson has it in the left corner. 8 on the clock. Paxson outside to Corzine. Top of the circle shot. Good. Dave Corzine has 10. The Bulls stay within 3. And 3:20 left in this third quarter. The Knicks were up 6 at the quarter, 7 at the half. Gerald Wilkins gives to Cummings right of the circle. He fires around and out. Michael Jordan the rebound. Jordan up court to Cureton. Earl baseline left. Hands to Corzine. Got his shot blocked. The Knicks come away with the ball. Here's Wilkins on the drive. Peels off to the left as the Bulls, Jordan and Paxson chase him out of the lane. 2:50 left in the third. Left wing Sparrow, 18-footer, bullseye. Sparrow with 16. I've got him 8 for 13 from the field. Brad Sellers over the top. Cureton in low left. He got fouled from behind. Foul is on Kenny Walker, and the Knicks take time with 2:38 left in the third quarter. 71-66. The Knicks lead it on the Bulls Basketball Network.
The Bulls would like to welcome some groups to tonight's game, including George's Piece of the Rock Lounge. We'd like to thank them.
35-120, the Celtics beat the Golden State Warriors. Harold Cureton on the free throw line with 2:38 left to go in the third quarter. Cureton on the season, 6 for 12 free throwing. And he misses the first one here. Cureton with 6 first half points. Second shot by Cureton. That's in. 71-67. Gerald Henderson spins on the dribble into the front court for the Knicks. Gives it up to Walker, top of the circle. Left side, Gerald Wilkins. He goes baseline left and lays it in. Gerald Wilkins just drove to the left baseline and scored. 13 for him, and the Knicks back to a 6-point lead. 2:16 left in this quarter. Michael Jordan on the walk to the left. Quick drive in for the left, lays it up. Nope. Patrick Ewing the rebound. Gerald Henderson at the controls for the Knicks. Standing dribble out top of the circle.
2 minutes.
Left side, he plays it to Wilkins. Out top of the key, Henderson. Right side, Walker. Kenny Walker at the foul line. Left side to Henderson. Left corner, Wilkins. Lean in shot, hits the side of the glass. Brad Sellers grabs it.
It was a good rebound, too.
Tough rebound. He was in traffic, off balance. Paxson, right corner shot, right through. John Paxson continues to have the hot hand. The Bulls stay within four. 73-69. Pax is 7 of 10 from the field in the game. Henderson off to the left for the Knicks, guarded by Paxson. Gerald Henderson stops the dribble. Kenny Walker against Sellers. Lean in, shot is in from the left side. Kenny Walker has 18. And the inbounds pass is tipped out of bounds by Gerald Henderson. The Bulls will have it. Let's take 10 for station identification on the Bulls network. And Turner in the game for the Bulls, replacing Michael Jordan. The Bulls have it in play to John Paxson. Minute 15 left, third quarter. Paxson outside left, hounded by Gerald Henderson. 15 to shoot. Paxson's picked up the dribble into Corzine, low left. Corzine against Ewing. Half hook in the lane. Rimming now. Tip try. Sellers is in.
Oh.
Brad Sellers with 10.
That was a finesse tip, Jim. He reached over to tap, but didn't make contact with the guy in front of him.
Exactly, John. He tipped that one in the same way he corralled that defensive rebound down here at the other end. 50 seconds left in the third quarter. It's a 4-point game. Kenny Walker off to the left, guarded by Sellers. Into Wilkins against Elston Turner. Gerald Wilkins, low left, double fake, then shoots. Good. Wilkins on the post up of Turner. 15 for Wilkins. 77-71. The Knicks keep the 6-point lead. 33 seconds left in the quarter. Shot clock at 17, about 15 difference. Off to the left is Paxson. He shoots out of the left corner. Got another one. John Paxson with 16. Bulls stay within four. Pax is filling it up tonight. 18 seconds left, sort of.
One
shot clock about 1.5 difference, I guess. Shot clock now at 11. Wilkins on the move down right of the lane. Feeds off to Cummings. Cummings down low right. He shoots under pressure. Missed it. Rebound battle inside. Won by Cureton. Traveling called on Earl Cureton, says Joe Crawford, with 2 seconds left in the third quarter.
Walker out or in.
They're wiping up a wet spot on the court. The Knicks
Knicks will take it. Foul line extended right, and Pat Cummings will make the inbounds pass. He looks low for Ewing. Cross court instead to Louis Orr. He juggles, then throws one at the basket, hits the rim. Third quarter is over. New York still leads it, but now the lead is four. It's the Knicks 77, the Bulls 73. Back after these messages on the Bulls Network. Knicks at 57% from the field, the Bulls at 43%. The Bulls out-rebounded the Knicks 16-9. Charles Oakley returns for the Bulls and gives the Bulls a front line of Oakley, Corzine, Sellers, Paxson, and Turner at the guard spots. John Paxson smoking tonight, 8 of 11 from the field. Paxson guarding Henderson in the New York front court. Here's Pat Cummings, low right, backing in on Oakley. A jump hook is around and out, and the rebound. Turner falls down, saves it to Sellers, though. No, Turner went out of bounds, said Joe Crawford. Boy, they were too aggressive on the boards. Three white shirts knocking the bejabbers out of each other.
You know what? I'll tell you something. That's what Cummings does. You said it before. He threw that ball up and tried to chase it down and get the rebound.
That ball did not touch out of bounds. It was held over the line, but it didn't touch on the replay. Sellers blocks Cartwright's shot from behind. Here come the Bulls back. Paxson on the drive in the front court. Cummings and Oakley had squared off.
He did it right there. Cummings is the guy that took a shot.
Technical foul has been called on Charles Oakley and on Cummings.
That's he on both of them. Coming off, they got tangled up in the back. Sellers made a great block on a shot going to the hoop by Cartwright. Elston Turner brought the ball up the court, and then they got tangled in the back.
Two tees.
Well, two tees, non-shooting.
Sellers inbounding. He comes into Turner. Oakley has it top of the circle. Left side Sellers. Brad Sellers scoop pass off inside, intended for Corzine. Went out of bounds. Corzine wasn't ready for the pass of the night.
But he got to wipe that scowl off his face doing it. That's right. He wasn't ready for it.
Henderson dancing on the dribble between the circles. Right of the key, Louis Orr. He drives into the lane, traveling on Louis Orr. Foul called on Brad Sellers. That's his second.
I was with you, buddy. I heard him blow the whistle and go with the hands out. No play.
Louis Orr will inbound it. Foul line extended right. He lobs it into Rory Sparrow. Sparrow under pressure of Paxson right side, and an offensive foul now against Louis Orr. Very spirited fourth quarter to this point. John Paxson walks it up for the Bulls, who have turned it over 15 times tonight. The Knicks turnover total has reached 11. Paxson in the left corner. 12 to shoot. Paxson pressured by Henderson. Fadeaway shot, foul line. Oh! John Paxson with 18. 9 for 12 from the field. The Bulls have cut it to 2. 10:48 left. Henderson right side leans over the dribble against Paxson. Works into the right corner. Out front, Louis Orr. He dribbles left one time. He's covered it up now against Sellers. Pat Cummings wide left, 6 to shoot. Cummings in the lane, shoots under pressure, missed the shot, but drew the foul on Brad Sellers. Pat Cummings shoots 2.
Played pretty good defense there for quite a while, Jim, but that's number 3. Crowd chanting defense and a 2-point lead by the Knicks. Now Cummings goes to the line.
He's a 72% free thrower who made both attempts in the first half tonight. Not many free throws shot in this game. Cummings rims it in. He has 13 points. He averages 11.4.
And all the points off of their bench.
The second one is also in, and the Knicks lead is 4 with 10 and a half minutes left. Elston Turner brings it up, hawked by Sparrow. Turner top of the key, right side Paxson, fakes past Henderson, dribbles into the right corner, into Oakley, low right. Charles a double fake, lean in, scoop, no, got his own rebound, laid it in. Charles Oakley, good effort underneath, keeps the Bulls within 2. Here comes Mr. Jordan. Michael at the scorer's table with 10 minutes left. Henderson in the lane, and a foul called on Paxson. John Paxson picks up his second foul as Michael Jordan returns, replacing Elston Turner.
Now the Knicks didn't shoot a free throw in that quarter, Jim, and now they come back. This is the third foul on the Bulls. Pax with his hand on the ball, little body, and at the line, Gerald Henderson, who has not shot at anything this evening so far.
He's a good free thrower, though, 85%, and he hits the first one. 80-77, the Knicks lead is three. Anderson drops them both in, and New York keeps... Now Oakley's been thrown out of the game. Charles Oakley ran over Henderson trying to get free, and Joe Crawford,
just said the foul. The foul was on him.
Crawford at first pointed to the dressing room. Then he just called a foul on Oakley. So now Cureton is in and Oakley is out. Not out of the game, however. He's still in the game. Just on the bench. New York hasn't played a Cartwright. Henderson with the ball back. Low left is Cartwright. Dumps it off to Sparrow. Foul line jumper. Good. Rory Sparrow is as hot as John Paxson tonight. Almost. Sparrow with 18 points, and the Knicks have a 6-point lead with 9:40 left. Rory Sparrow off to the, or Paxson off to the left, guarded by Henderson. Top of the circle, Sellers. 10 to shoot. Jordan down the lane. Scoop pass to Corzine. He laid it in. Good pass by Michael Jordan. Dave Corzine with 12. Bulls have never led. They've trailed by as many as 10, and they've cut it to 1. Louis Orr, top of the circle. Right side is Sparrow. Shot clock at 10. Left to the key, Orr. He chases down an errant pass off to the left, 6 to shoot. Cartwright left of the lane. Louis Orr, left corner, shot over Sellers, missed. Michael Jordan, the rebound. He went up and caught it going up. A hoop makes it a 2-point game. Jordan in the front court against Rory Sparrow. Sparrow tips his pass away. Michael gets it back, saves it to Corzine. Paxson left to the key. He fires, rimming. No. Rebound, Cummings lost it out of bounds. What's the call?
Cureton.
Foul on Cureton. First foul on Cureton. Fourth team foul on the Bulls already. 8:44 left in the game. 83-79. The Knicks a 4-point lead. Gerald Henderson controlling for the Knicks. On the walk to the right against Paxson. Sparrow has it outside, guarded by Jordan. Wide left is Louis Orr. Shot clock at 10. Orr left of the key has picked it up. Sellers, Corzine pokes a pass away. The Knicks keep it 3 to shoot. Sparrow out to the left. Force up shot left of the key. Air ball. Bulls get it after a 24-second violation. Gerald Wilkins comes in for the Knicks. And Gerald Henderson goes out.
Good defense by the Bulls. They come right back. I'd like to see Pax have one more second on that chatter, a half a second to collect himself on that three-pointer. He wasn't quite together.
8:15 left. Paxson in the front court, guarded by Sparrow. Shot clock at 15. Paxson on the drive, top of the key, right side Sellers. Hook pass back to Paxson. He steps in, right back to Sellers. Brad to the hoop, missed the dunk, drew the foul.
It's all right, power move. Boy, he and Pax played patty cake with that ball. And it's a wonder nobody got caught in the three-second lane, Jim, but it was really popping around. Pax drove, kicked it back over to Brad Sellers. He had the shot. He went up, collected himself, and tried to slam it on down through, but he'll shoot two free throws as Corzine now hits the Pines. Charles Oakley back for him.
Kenny Walker back for the Knicks. That foul was on Cartwright. Pat Ewing also in the game. Ewing, Cartwright, and Walker up front, and Sellers rims the free throw good. 11 points for Brad Sellers. That's a new high for him.
One of many, we hope.
Yeah. He seems to get better every time out. Sellers again. That's it. Sellers with 12. The Bulls within two at 8 minutes left. Sparrow controls for the Knicks. Off to the left against Paxson. Into Cartwright. Here's a ball knocked loose. It's still loose. Sellers down on the deck. It trickles off to Sparrow, who shoots it up. No good. Baseline left. Cartwright got the rebound and laid it in. Cartwright with 12. 85-81. The Knicks with a stranglehold on this lead tonight. Paxson outside left. Paxson stops the dribble into Jordan, low left. Back to Paxson. Long outside jumper. No good left wing. Cartwright the rebound for the Knicks. Wants a guard to come back, and Wilkins does to get the ball. Sparrow on the dribble right side, guarded by Paxson. 11 on the shot clock. Out front, Kenny Walker against Sellers. Inside pass stolen by Jordan. They tried to go to Ewing.
Michael Jordan storms it up. Jordan pinched off to Paxson. He laid it in, coming in from the left side. 20 for Paxson. It's a two-point game again with 6:57 left. Pax with a new season high, 20. Here's Wilkins, left baseline, leaning shot, blocked by Sellers. Traveling call on Gerald Wilkins. The Bulls have a chance to tie after this timeout. The stadium is buzzing. 14,328. Timeout Chicago, 6:44 for the game. New York 85, the Bulls 83. Back after these messages on the Bulls Network.
Seen him make a graduation from some high school play at this level to some collegiate play, and now playing like a bona fide professional number one. He's blocked some shots. He has not come down with the body. He has rebounded extremely well, and he's getting the call now at crunch time.
And he'll inbound the ball to John Paxson at three-quarter court as the Bulls have a chance to tie. Pax walks into the front court. Rory Sparrow guards him. Paxson dancing on the dribble out between the circles. Left side is Oakley. Michael Jordan in the left corner. Quick drive to the hoop. Tried to dunk it and drew the foul. Michael Jordan shoots two. That foul is on Bill Cartwright.
That's a tough way to earn a living, boy. Michael went around. Everybody drew Ewing, who knew what he was going to do, and Cartwright, the seven-footer. But they come down on Michael. He's to the line now where he's missed three, made his last two.
Jordan's free throw is good. Now he shoots for the tie with 6:29 remaining. 23 points for Michael Jordan in the game. Came in shooting 81% from the foul line. It's a tie game. The Bulls have climbed the mountain. Sparrow outside left. Walker head of the key. Gives it up to Wilkins right of the circle. Top of the key, Rory Sparrow. 10 to shoot. Kenny Walker, baseline left, shoots under pressure and hits it from behind the backboard. 20 points for Kenny Walker. What a tough shot he hit. Wow. Here's Paxson on the attack for the Bulls, who again need a hoop to tie. Charles Oakley holding it off to the left. Brad Sellers in the left corner against Walker, 8 to shoot. Michael Jordan left of the lane, long outside jumper, good. 26 for Jordan, the game tied at 87, 5:40 left.
Who's going to blink, big guy?
That's right. Rory Sparrow, head of the key, right corner, Wilkins. Wilkins right of the lane, Sellers has fallen down, Wilkins to the hoop, Jordan blocked the shot from behind. Michael the steal. Jordan takes it in on Kenny Walker, and he's fouled by Walker.
Boy, Brad Sellers slipped and fell in the lane. Wilkins took the ball to the basket, ran over Oakley. Michael blocked the shot. Walker digs on back. Michael takes him, now tries to go to the middle. Walker put a hand on him, and now another hand on the wrist. Michael shoots to break the tie.
5:23 left. When Jordan blocked the shot, he appeared to foul him. Jordan hits the free throw. That's 27.
Yubi Brown all over Joey Crawford.
Giving him a real barber job.
Now, he's not the first one to do that tonight, is he?
Jordan rims the second one good. The Bulls lead by two. 5:23 left. 89-87. Sparrow right side kills the dribble. Out front, Walker. Walker on the dribble against Sellers. Kenny Walker, left corner, Gerald Wilkins, he fires, no. Ewing the rebound, lost it out of bounds, tipped out by Oakley. Charles Oakley had inside position on Ewing, but couldn't quite control the rebound.
Tough duty, boy.
Yeah, you got it.
The Knicks have it in play to Cartwright. Outside is Wilkins, guarded by Jordan. Sparrow's pop-out shot, good, right of the key. Rory Sparrow down low right, he's got 20. The game tied at 89 and 4:55 remaining. Paxson controlling for the Bulls. Between the circles, Pax works it left on the dribble. Shot clock at 12. Sellers has it wide right. Michael Jordan with it now left of the key. Six to shoot. Jordan on the move down the lane. Shoots under pressure and draws the foul. Michael Jordan shoots two. Rory
with his second foul. Yeah, the Knicks with four team fouls.
Knicks are waving the towels on the bench now, and Sparrow goes up. He got hit in the back by Walker, I thought, and then Sparrow got him on the right arm, but Gerald Henderson waving a towel off that bench. If they catch that out of the side of their eye, it'll be all over, won't it?
You know it. Jordan hits the free throw. Michaels hit seven straight after missing his first three. Now he shoots for 30. If he gets it, he will be averaging 40 points a game against the Knicks this year. He gets it. The Bulls lead by two. 4:38 left. Sparrow on the attack for the Knicks. Outside left against Paxson. Lob into Cartwright. Down low. Lost the ball. Jordan the steal.
Beautiful work. Jordan went in the front and his teammate Michael came behind to steal it.
Jordan walks into the front court. 4:19 left. Wide left is Oakley, 10 on the shot clock. Out front, Cureton. Left corner, Jordan, 5 to shoot. 4 on the clock, Jordan on the drive, underneath, reverse layup, and a foul call. Michael Jordan on the line. This foul is on Patrick Ewing. 4 fouls on Ewing, 4:06 for the game.
Beautiful play. We talked about the steal. Cureton was in front of Cartwright. Michael came to help his teammate and just stripped the ball. Was able to come down. Then they give it to Michael, clear it out. And a bump by Ewing on the side. Michael went in to try to make the shot. Now a two-point lead. He tries for a couple more.
Jordan's free throw, dead center. 9 straight from the line. UB Brown wants time. The Bulls have their biggest lead of the game, and 14,000-plus come to their feet in the stadium. 4:06 left. Chicago 92, New York 89. Back after these messages on the Bulls Basketball Network.
Defensive performance so far by the Bulls.
Michael Jordan strolls back to the free throw line to complete his 2 free throw attempts here. Jordan with 9 straight from the foul line after missing his first three. 31 points for him in the game, 9 in this fourth quarter.
Well, you mentioned something, hit it on the head. If he makes this, it'd be the biggest lead in the game for the Bulls.
That's it. New York led early by as many as 10. Jordan drills it. The Bulls lead by 4 with 4:06 left. Ronnie Sparrow's played all but 2 minutes of the game, and he walks into the front court calling a play. Outside left, Kenny Walker. Brad Sellers on him in that rookie matchup. 12 to shoot. Kenny Walker passes aside. Jordan, a steal intended for Wilkins. Michael Jordan is winning it at both ends of the floor now. Here's a pass knocked out of bounds by Patrick Ewing on a pass intended for Oakley on the left wing. The Bulls get a reprieve.
Michael.
Brad Sellers will inbound it. He brings it in to Paxson. Oakley, top of the key. Lob pass for Jordan, low right. Michael laid it up. It's hit off the back. The backboard was smacked with a ball up there. Again, no goaltend. Here's Wilkins coming down in the left corner. Down low, Patrick Ewing. Ewing wheels in with a jump hook. It's missed. Rebound tipped away and out of bounds to the Knicks as Cureton and Oakley couldn't quite get there. But they kept it away from Ewing.
Doug tried to tap the ball in like nobody was looking to keep it in bounds.
Kenny Walker will put it in play. 3:23 left. Foul line extended right. Walker flips it into Gerald Wilkins. Out front, Walker guarded by Sellers. 18 to shoot. Walker with a pass into Ewing. Left corner. Ewing comes up shooting. Missing. Michael Jordan the rebound. Hey, lost the ball to Wilkins as Jordan, I think, fought Oakley for the ball. And then Gerald Wilkins, a jam and a foul on Brad Sellers.
It looked like Michael Jordan was fighting with Charles Oakley for that rebound, Jim, and it came loose. Wilkins got it, saw what was going to happen, went down the middle, knew he was going to stuff it. Sellers went up to try to stop it, and boom, on down and in. Beautiful play. Wilkins weak at the foul line so far tonight.
1 for 4 on the night. Missed that one, and Cureton the rebound. It's still a 2-point Chicago lead with 3 minutes left. 93-91. John Paxson in the front court. New York sets up the half-court trap and an illegal defense against the Knicks on Kenny Walker. And so the Bulls are back on the free throw line and they'll get a new 24. Michael Jordan will shoot it. So many times tonight we've seen the guys in the white shirts go so aggressive at the ball that they have lost the rebound because they have fought each other off. Michael Jordan knocks the free throw down. The Bulls lead by three with 2:54 left. And now the Bulls have it. Foul line extended right. And they have it in play to Paxson. They've got a new 24, remember. John Paxson between the circles. On the walking dribble, comes left to Michael Jordan. Doug Collins saying clear out. Jordan tend to shoot in from the left, runs into people, had the shot blocked. Patrick Ewing comes down with it. Sparrow into the front court. Sparrow left to the lane, to the hoop, lays it in.
Oh, they opened the C for him.
22 for Sparrow. The Knicks within one and 2:22 left. The Bulls are in a must-score trip here. Paxson on the walk to the right, gives to Jordan in the right corner. 12 to shoot. Michael on the drive, baseline right, pumps the shot up. No, tipped in by Oakley. No basket, offensive goaltending.
We're way in the first half, Joe. Michael Jordan goes up in the crowd, hangs, puts the ball off. Looks like it's coming off. Michael does, it is touched on top.
Now what did he got call? Thrown on the floor. 18 on the shot clock, 2:02 for the game. The Knicks will have the ball to put in play again. The Bulls lead by one. Kenny Walker flips it inbounds to Sparrow. Washington beat Houston tonight by 16. Off the ball, we get a whistle.
Carroll.
A foul on Oakley as Cartwright came through. Oakley with his fourth and Bill Cartwright on the line for the first time in the game, a 71% free thrower. The Bulls with three timeouts and a 20. New York with three timeouts. Times out, I should say. Cartwright gets ready. He pats it and delivers it. Around and in, the game is tied at 94. Minute 56 left. Cartwright again. New York by one. The Bulls have it in play, and Michael Jordan walks it up. 95-94. Charles Oakley with the ball way off to the right, 12 on the shot clock. Curitan has it out high right. Jordan with it back, wide right. Michael on the drive, baseline right, pumps the shot up, banked it in, drew the foul. The foul is on Patrick Ewing, his fifth.
He beats his man going down low. Gerald Wilkins comes up. Ewing stood there pretty good, in my opinion.
Yep.
Stood there pretty good, in my opinion. But Michael gets the basket and a chance to put him up by two.
35 points for Jordan in the game. A minute 36 left. The free throw is good. Chicago by two, 97-95. Sparrow at the controls. On the dribble, off to the right, guarded by Paxson. Off the ball, an illegal defense against the Bulls, and that's the second one of the game.
Michael Jordan.
Isn't it?
I think that's the first on the Bulls.
Okay, you're right. First. I thought there was one on the first half. New 24 for the Knicks with a minute 25 left.
First and last 2 minutes.
Sparrow dumps it down low right. And to Cartwright, he almost traveled. His half hook is missed. Charles Oakley, a big rebound with a minute 15 remaining. Michael Jordan walks it up. 97-95 Bulls. Wide right is Charles Oakley. A minute 4 left. Jordan low right, in deep, turnaround shot, missed it. Kip Sellers, no. Cartwright the rebound, 57 seconds left. Rory Sparrow, left side, Wilkins, baseline, left to the hoop, fakes, has the shot blocked by Sellers, tipped out of bounds by the Knicks, the Bulls have it. Brad Sellers, a big play. Timeout, Chicago, with 50 seconds left. Timeout with a score. The Bulls 97, New York 95. Back after these messages on the Bulls Network. Timeline. Each team with two times out remaining. The Bulls also have a 20 left. And Doug Collins telling Brad Sellers, if you need it, Brad, we've got a 20. The Bulls have blocked six shots in the game, two apiece, Jordan, Curitan, Sellers. Ewing has all three New York blocks. Sellers inbounds to Oakley. Michael Jordan has it out front. 46 seconds left. Shot clock at 19. Yama, you want a 2-for-1 here. Michael Jordan, quick drive, baseline left, reverse layup, no. Rebound tipped around, it's loose, still loose, still loose. Curitan trying to dig it out. The Knicks have it with 33 seconds left and a foul on Brad Sellers. Five fouls on Brad Sellers.
And that ball going down the floor. Earl Curitan trying to throw it out. Four blue shirts around it, and then Brad Sellers gives him a foul. It might be a good one, Jim.
Gerald Wilkins, 1-for-5 free throwing tonight.
If he misses, get on that line and get it going.
33 seconds left. He drills it. 97-96. 18 points for Gerald Wilkins in the game. Now he shoots for the tie. Game. The Bulls aren't going to take a timeout. They're going to take it at the end line. John Paxson brings it up. Shot clock at 17. Eight difference, remember. Michael Jordan off to the right. Triple team. Jordan a jump pass, cross court left. Two Sellers, 10 seconds. On the shot clock. Jordan has it. Michael in from the left. Down low, shoots it up. Banked it in. 13 seconds left. Michael Jordan puts the Bulls up by two. With the final 13 ticks after these messages on the Bulls Network. The Bulls are trying to hang on. They've got a 2-point lead with 13 seconds remaining. Michael Jordan with 38 points in the game and 16 of them here in the fourth quarter. Well, the Bulls were off for a week. The enthusiasm remains in the stadium. The Bulls are under their average tonight, attendance-wise, but not in decibels.
Oh, boy, that's right. 13 to go. They're taking it at the half-court line.
The Knicks with one timeout left now. If they burn it, trying to get it in play.
Five
16
fouls.
Straight points for Michael Jordan in this fourth quarter.
Five fouls on both teams.
Sparrow to inbound. At the timeline, Paxson puts pressure on him. Sparrow looks to bring it in. He comes in to Cartwright. 11 seconds. Wilkins in the left corner. In the lane. Running hook is in. Tie game with 8 seconds left. The Bulls get it in play to Michael Jordan. No timeout. Michael into the front court. Left corner shot by Jordan. Good! Scored 18 consecutive points for the Bulls. That is a Bulls record, and I believe it might be an NBA record. The old Bulls record was by Mickey Johnson as Michael Jordan without a timeout. The Bulls didn't take time. He just took it down into the corner and drilled it with 1 second left.
That's right. There was 8 seconds on the clock, Jimmy. Looked over for a timeout. Normally we see that. A guy will call for a timeout. A coach will call for a timeout. Doug Collins does not like to have that defense set up on you. Give him a chance to know, talk it over what to do. He went down. He knew if Michael had the opening, he could go one-on-one in that 8 second period. He did, and he made a crunching shot from the outside.
101-99. One tick left.
Last timeout by the Knicks.
The Knicks have nothing left. Remember, the clock starts as soon as someone inbounds touches the ball. Let's see how the Bulls play it if they elect to double away from the ball, or if they play it straight up and put pressure on the man inbounding. Elston Turner coming into the game. Doug Collins getting his best defensive lineup he can out there. Turner, Cureton, Oakley, Sellers, and Jordan. New York, Walker, Cartwright, Ewing, Wilkins, and Sparrow.
Who's
Ewing
Sparrow?
Will inbound it.
Who's got
Nobody,
Sparrow?
Who's got Rory Sparrow? Finally, Charles Oakley comes to cover him. Ewing inbounds Wilkins, three-pointer from the left bank. No, the Bulls win. The Bulls have run their home record to 4-1, their overall record to 6-3. As they drop the New York Knicks for the second time this season, the final score, the Chicago Bulls 101, the New York Knicks 99, Michael Jordan with a club record 18 consecutive points down the stretch to victory.
So while artists, musicians, and scientists spend lifetimes achieving greatness, it took just 4 weeks of basketball for Jordan to establish himself in the minds of most as the greatest. His most memorable feats took even less time, usually just a couple of seconds, often the final ones. Here's our top 10.
At number 10.
3 seconds. Jordan's foursome shot.
Oh, yes!
Win. Michael Jordan saves the day. And the Bulls win.
Number 9.
Jordan with 2 seconds left. Jordan to win.
Jordan being Michael Jordan.
Number 8.
Michael. To win it.
And he does! Ring it up! Michael Jordan has beaten the Hawks again!
Coming in at number 7.
2.5 seconds. Jordan again!
Hey, this has to come.
He has done it again! Almost from the same spot.
Number 6.
Jordan with 4 seconds. Takes, shoots.
Number 5.
Jordan putting moves on Russell. We're down to 2. Now to 1. Here's Jordan. Yes! It is all over. The Chicago Bulls have won at the buzzer.
I can't really fathom the idea that everybody's watching the game, TV and even on the building, knows you're going to get the ball, knows you're going to take the shot. And yet you're able to come through in that situation.
At number 4.
Time winding down. Michael for 3.
Yes! A winner! Unbelievable!
Number 3.
Breaking the clock. Jordan for the win.
Yes! I did it again! He is now back! Holy mackerel!
Number 2.
Here's Michael at the foul line. A shot on Elo.
Good! The Bulls win it! They win it!
Set the Cleveland Cavaliers. Michael Jordan hits it at the foul line. 101-100.
And number 1.
Jordan, a drive. Hang. Fire. Yes! He scores! The Bulls lead 87-86.
So what should Michael Jordan do next? We asked, you answered, nearly half of you say he should work in an NBA front office. Let's hear from the man himself. A short time ago, MJ spoke with our Michelle Tafoya.
Relax.
Michael. Michael Jordan. You are on the right path. But to find what you desire requires a great effort. You look thirsty. Gatorade?
Thanks. I've come.
I know why you have come. You wish to know the meaning of life.
And?
Life is a sport. Drink it up.
That's what I figured.
Disrespect me.
Tell me I'm older. Tell me I'm slower. Tell me I can no longer fly. I want you to.
Michael Jordan is CEO Jordan.
Half time at the United Center with the Bulls leading 62.
Get the PE.
ASAP.
Proceed. Authorized. Denied. Give me the Nikkei clothes and the Detroit score. Double mesh.
Double mesh.
Double mesh.
Double mesh.
Double mesh.
Double mesh.
Double mesh. Make the logo bigger.
And the second half is about to begin here at the United Center. Michael Jordan of the Bulls.
MJ. Those new Air Jordans.